Myself, Dr. Vivek Sharma. I am presently associated with Institute of Management Studies, Devi Ahilya University, Indore, as a faculty of management with a specialization in quantitatives and psychology. Dear friends, today we will be talking about improving the research or sojourn from research papers to projects and consultancy. As teachers, it is necessary to have an understanding of a specific needs of a body of knowledge. As we all are management teachers first, understanding the specific needs of the stream are required to be talked about. Teaching management requires some specific skills as compared to the teachers in any other branch of social sciences. Though every branch of social science has its practical applications, but when it comes to management, academicians and practitioners, they are not in sync and also not in touch with each other on a regular basis. All management teachers who are not a part of any top B schools like the IIMs always feel that they are not teaching students what is required by the corporate world, and the same is felt by the employees of these students. The other big challenge which faculty members are facing is related to the quality research and not being a part of their regular academic work. Teachers feel that they are not having the required resources and the skills to go for quality research. They consider themselves to be handicapped when it comes to making a balance between research and other tasks. Many researchers and academicians in their writings have tried to show the relevance of research for the teachers. Teachers can be effective if they are involved in the research, as they can support their classroom discussions with findings. We very well know that majority of textbooks are not updated, and so the major advantage with the research is that it helps the teachers in imparting students the current happenings of the world. And definitely, the research increases the understanding of the subject of the faculty. Before I venture into the details of this session topic, it is important that we have deep understanding of the word sojourn, as it has tremendous significance in the current topic. Sojourn means taking a break. So, as a management teacher, take a break from mundane, vanilla publishing, academic research, and move towards project and consultancy based research. Now, the question arises in our minds that what is the difference between research published in academic journals and projects or consultancy based research? We very well know that the rationale of the academic research papers in majority of the cases is the existing gap found during review of literature. The reviewers also rate the quality of these research papers based on the exhaustive review of literature done by the researchers. These papers are written to have an in-depth understanding of the research topic, and so there are great chances that these research topics or problems may not be of any much interest to the entrepreneurs and or practitioners. While on researchers coming out of either consultancy or project are directly linked with the business problems. The popular term for the researchers, which are very much useful for the practitioners or the problem itself, comes from the industry, is action research. It is defined as the research initiated to solve an immediate problem or a reflective process of progressive problem solving led by individuals working with others in terms of as or as part of a community of practice to improve the way they address issues and solve problems. Action research can be engaged in by an individual teacher, a collaborative group of colleagues sharing a common concern, or an entire institute, department, faculty. These three different approaches to organizing for research serve three compatible yet distinct purposes. First is building the reflective practitioner. Second, making progress on the overall priorities of the institute. And the third is building professional cultures. Now, we will talk about why action research now. In the present time, the best strategy that can be right is the action research. That is true for a host of reasons. The most important of them be professionalize teaching, enhance the motivation and efficacy of a weary faculty, meet the needs of an increasingly diverse student body, achieve success with standards-based reforms. Now we will cover each of them one by one. First, professionalizing teaching. Teaching and management has evolved in a manner that makes it more like blue-collar work than a professional undertaking. Although blue-collar workers are expected to do their jobs with vigilance and vigor, it is also assumed that their tasks will be routine, straightforward, and therefore easily handled by an isolated worker with only the occasional support of a supervisor. Professional work, on the other hand, is expected to be complex and non-routine and will generally require collaboration among practitioners to produce satisfactory results with the exploding knowledge base on teaching and learning and the heightened demands on teachers to help the students achieve mastery of their objectives. The inadequacy of the blue-collar model for teaching is becoming much clearer. When management teachers are involved in action research, their workplace begins to take on more of the favor of the professional workplaces. This can be said because when teachers begin engaging their colleagues in discussions of real-world corporate issues, the multiple perspectives that emerge and thus frame of the dialogue tend to produce wiser professional decisions. Other than professional approach, the second reason can be enhancing teacher motivation and efficacy management. Teaching has always been difficult, but now it isn't just the demand of the present education world that are wearing teachers down. Students increasingly bring more problems into the classroom. Parental and societal expectations keep increasing, and financial cutbacks make it clear that today's teachers are being asked to do more with less. Academic faculty who are attempting to allocate their limited time now have many more opportunities and obligations. These opportunities and obligations include traditional teaching, executive education, internet teaching, serving as expert witness, and activities with academic centers, university service, overload teaching, doctoral programs, contract, grant research, and recruiting. Consequently, teacher burnout has become the plague of modern times. With these conditions, many of you may be asking, am I making any difference? Researchers, of all the negative pressures on us, the sheer nobility of the work keeps we, the educators, on the job, but only so long as we get credible answers to the efficacy question. However, without credible evidence that the work we are doing is making a difference, it is hard to imagine that we are still sticking with this difficult and poorly compensated line of work. Fortunately, research evidence shows that teachers who elected to integrate the use of data in their classroom teaching are getting the payoff, which in itself is a vitally energizing force. Meeting the needs of diverse student body is the third reason which we will cover now. The institutes in which we as teachers are taking classes, the students are quite varied in knowledge, background and approach towards learning. It is nowadays imperative that management teachers have a strong content background in each of the subjects they teach. Be familiar with the range of student differences in their classrooms. Specifically, in our country where diversity is quite high, and be capable of diagnosing and prescribing appropriate instructional modifications based upon a knowledge of students. As management teachers, great personal satisfaction comes from playing a role in creating successful solutions to continually changing puzzles. Conversely, if teachers are expected to robotically implement outdated approaches, especially when countless new challenges are arriving at their door, the frustration can become unbearable. The fourth and the last point to be discussed by us will be achieving success in a standards-based system. Most management institutes expect the standards to be rigorous and meaningful, and that they expect all students to meet the standards at the mastery level. Do we as a society know with certainty how to achieve universal student success? However, the reality is that no large system anywhere in the world has ever been successful in getting every student to master a set of meaningful objectives. If we accept the truth of this statement, then we need to acknowledge the fact that achieving the goal of universal student mastery will not be easy. Most people will agree that it is a most noble endeavor in which to invest energy and a worthy goal for any faculty to pursue. The reality is that our institutions will not prevail with the challenges inherent in the student movement unless they encourage experimentation, inquiry and dialogue by those pioneers who are working towards meeting those challenges. For this reason, it is imperative that these 21st century pioneers and teachers conduct the research on standards attainment themselves. So the time is right for action research. Teachers and institutions that seize this opportunity and begin investing in the power of inquiry will find that they are recreating the professional practice of education in their locale as a meaningful and rewarding pursuit. Conversely, those colleges and universities that are willing to invest in the wisdom of practice will likely find it increasingly hard to fill their classroom with enough teachers who are both capable of and willing to tackle the challenges that lie ahead. Now, with the understanding of academic research and action research, we should try to know how the journey can take place or how we can migrate from one end to another. So, comparing a researcher and a consultant is the first thing to be done. A researcher defines problems and tries to solve them. So does a consultant. A researcher is a knowledge worker. So, as a consultant, researchers tend to work alone. Many consultants do as well. At this level, the roles appear to be very similar. So, are the two terms simply two different names for a very similar activity? Possibly, but I don't think so. A key difference between the roles is emphasis. A consultant is more interested in practice, and good consultants are give theory to contribute to their work. In contrast, a researcher is more interested in testing a theory or developing new theories. Good researchers use data from practice to inform their work. That is, they test theories or develop new theory. So, the consultant is occupied with task of applying the concepts and theories to the industry to help the practitioner increase his productivity and efficiency. It is required to understand research as that research is not only a set of skills, but also a way of thinking. With this framework of thinking, you usually question what you observe and make an attempt to further explore, understand, and explain your observation and draw conclusions and inferences to enhance your practice skills and their knowledge base. It is looking at your practice or work situation inquisitively, critically, and analytically to gain an in-depth knowledge of its rationale, relevance, effectiveness, and efficiency. You develop an attitude that encourages you to challenge different aspects of your work situations, to question their purpose, relevance, and validity, to find their strengths, weaknesses, and to investigate the possibilities and ways for further improvements and refinements. Research developed in this thinking inquisitive perspective in you. Thinking in this research mode as a practitioner, you develop the ability to ask yourself questions such as, what am I doing? Why am I doing this? How is it affecting my clients or consumers? How can I improve my work? Such questions naturally come to your mind as a practitioner, and as a researcher, you make attempts to find the answers. It is to find answers to such questions that you need to have research skills. When research is considered in this perspective, then only the gap between academic research and consultancy-based research will reduce with time. Now, the most important part of this particular session, why we are here, is how can this be done? As we are all ready to change and are still considering academic research to be much easier, and that the consultancy is not our cup of tea. But now is the right time when we all should seriously think about working on research projects which can be further converted into research papers. We should not wait for the industry to call us for consultancy, but we should move forward and take some small projects. They can be small case-based studies to start with and convert them into research work. What I want to say by this is that we should do research in industry so that the output is both a research paper as well as a consultancy. We should not move ahead to consider both research and consultancy as two sides of the same coin. This can be one of the way as proposed by me. On brainstorming, we may come up with different and better ways. But the most important part is that we should now start thinking on these grounds to make ourselves a better and an updated management teacher. Thank you. Yeah.